गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, आई होप यू आर यूटिलाइजिंग योर टाइम वाइजली। टुडे वी विल डू द चैप्टर नंबर 5। द नेम ऑफ द चैप्टर इज सॉर्टिंग मटेरियल्स इनटू ग्रुप्स। व्हाट डू यू मीन बाय सॉर्टिंग? सॉर्टिंग मीन्स सेपरेटिंग मटेरियल ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ देयर सिमिलैरिटीज एंड डिसिमिलैरिटीज। देयर आर मोर देन अ मिलियन काइंड्स ऑफ लिविंग and non-living things on earth, but they can be sorted out into various sets or groups. हम सबको मालूम है हमारी धरती पे millions of living and non-living things are there. इनको individually study करना बहुत मुश्किल है. That's why we classify them into the different groups. It helps in studying their property easily. When we go to our school library, for example, when we go to a school library, we see that in the library, the different subject books are placed in different section. Why it is so? It helps to find the books easily. The process of grouping things on the basis of some common properties is called the classification. Now, next is material. Materials. We see a variety of things around us. Many different things are made up of similar kind of material, or one material can be used to make different things. We know that every object is made up of some material. Some objects are made up of one kind of material. For example, chair is made up of plastic or wood. A glass tumbler is made up of thick glass. Some objects are made up of different kinds of material. For example, see this pencil. This is made up of graphite and wood. We know that all materials are made up of matter. Matter is anything that occupies space and has mass. Matter is anything that occupies space and has mass. The glass we use to drink water, the air we breathe, the water we drink are all matter. Glass, water, air, all these things occupy space and have mass. These are matter. Matter exists in three states: solid, liquid, and gases. We know that the solids have definite shape as well as definite volume. See this pencil. This pencil is in solid state. It has definite shape and definite volume. Liquid has no definite shape but definite volume. For example, take a glass of water and pour this water into a bowl. The water takes the shape of the bowl. This shows that the liquid has no definite shape but have definite volume. The volume of the water in bowl remain same. Finally, the gases have neither the definite shape nor definite volume. They can move in all direction. Important properties of materials. Materials are classified according to their properties. Beside properties like color, size, odor, taste and shape, other important properties include solubility, magnetic property, conductivity, transparency and luster. Now first is solubility. The solubility is when we add like salt or sugar into the liquid, they fully dissolve into the water or in a liquid. This show that they are soluble in liquids. When we add chalk or dust particles into the liquid, they will not dissolve into them. These are the insoluble substances. Magnetic property. Such substances are attract or repel towards the magnet. This is called the magnetic property of that substances. Conductivity. Such substances allow heat or current to pass through them. This is called the conductivity of the material. Transparency. Some materials allow light to pass through them, like glass. This is called the transparent substances. Luster. Some materials give the shiny appearance like silver, gold. This is called the luster. Different materials show different properties. The materials are classified into the different groups according on the basis of these properties. However, many times material that look very different from each other exhibit similar properties. Let us study these properties and see how they can be used to classify material on this space. Properties of different states of matter. In solid, the molecules are closely packed. The intermolecular space between the molecules are very less. So they have definite shape and definite volume. They cannot be compressed at all because the molecules are tightly packed. For example, ice, chair, table, glass, book, computer, bottles, common salt, etc. In liquid, the particles are less closely packed to each other as compared to the solid. The intermolecular space between them is more as compared to the solid. So they have definite volume but not definite shape. They take the shape of the container in which they are kept. For example, water, milk, juice, soda, etc. Gases. In gas, the particles are loosely packed and free to move. They can move in all directions. They neither have definite shape nor definite volume. They are highly compressible. For example, perfume, water vapors, air, oxygen, hydrogen, etc. Materials are classified on the basis of some common properties like solubility, magnetic property, thermal conductivity, transparency, luster, roughness, floating or sinking. Now, first of all, we are going to discuss the solubility. Solubility of solids in liquid first is. It is the ability of a substance to dissolve in a liquid or solvent. The most commonly used solvent is water. Different substances have different solubility. Substances like sugar and common salt dissolve completely in water. Therefore, they are called the soluble substances. The substances which are fully dissolved in water, these substances are called the soluble substances. The most commonly used solvent is water. For example, I show you one picture. When we add 1 spoon of sugar into the water and stir it properly, it dissolves fully in water and forms the sugar solution. Clear sugar solution. This shows that sugar is dissolved into the water. Sugar is a soluble substance. I give you one example more. When we add 1 spoon of sugar into the milk or in a coffee, when we drink it, do you find sugar granules in the milk? No, because it is fully dissolved into the milk or in the coffee. It means sugar is fully dissolved into the liquids. As same with the salt. When we add 1 spoon of salt into the water and stir it properly, we will find out that the salt is fully dissolved into the water. This shows that sugar and salt are the soluble substances because they are fully dissolved into the water. But some substances which are not dissolved into the water, these substances are called the insoluble substances. See, certain substances like sulfur which do not dissolve in water are called the insoluble substances. But sulfur dissolves in carbon disulfide. The substances which are not dissolved into the water is called the insoluble substances. For example, when we add 1 spoon of sand into the water and stir it properly, we will find out that a muddy solution is formed. Leave this solution for some time. We will find out that the sand is settled at the bottom of the jar. This shows that the sand is not soluble in water. The substances which are not dissolved in water are called the insoluble substances. For example, sand, chalk dust, etc. Next is solubility of liquids in liquids. like solids. Some liquids mix completely in water, like alcohol, fruit squash, soda, etc. However, some liquids like petrol, oil do not mix with water. The liquids which mix with completely in water are called the miscible liquids, while the liquids which do not mix with water are called the immiscible liquids. The liquids which are fully mixed with water are called the miscible liquids, like fruit squash, alcohol, soda, etc. But some liquids like kerosene oil, coconut oil, petrol, diesel, all these liquids are not dissolved into the water. These are called the immiscible liquids. I show you one picture. When we add water into the orange juice, it is fully mixed into the water and make this. This show that it is fully mixed into the water. This is a miscible liquids. But some liquids are not soluble in water. These liquids are called the immiscible liquids, like kerosene oil, petrol, diesel, mustard oil, etc. For example, when we add 1 spoon of mustard oil into the water, we will find out that this oil float on the surface of the water, because oil is less dense than water and therefore it floats on the surface of the water. These liquids are called the immiscible liquids, which are not dissolved in water. Now let us do one activity. Check the solubility of given substances and record your finding. First is coconut oil. It is insoluble, because when we add coconut in water, it float on water because it is less denser than water. Lemon juice, when we made lemonade, lemon juice is fully dissolved in water. This is soluble. Kerosene oil, insoluble. Salt, soluble, because it is fully dissolved in water. Chalk, insoluble. Vinegar, soluble. These are some materials which are soluble and insoluble in water. Next is solubility of gases in water. Water is a most common solvent because many substances dissolve easily in water. Many gases like carbon dioxide and oxygen are soluble in water and form the basis for the survival of the aquatic plants and animals. See in this picture, the aquatic plants and animals survive in water because the oxygen and carbon dioxide is soluble in water. The aquatic animals breathe in the oxygen, that is dissolved in water. In the same way, aquatic plants also survive in water because the carbon dioxide is also soluble in water. They breathe in the oxygen and carbon dioxide, that is already dissolved in water. But some gases like hydrogen, helium, nitrogen, these gases are not soluble in water. These are the insoluble in water. Next one is magnetic property or magnetism. The property of attraction of a substance towards a magnet is called the magnetic property or magnetism. Some materials are attracted towards the magnet. These materials are called the magnetic materials. For example, iron, nickel, cobalt, etc. I show you some iron nails. When I bring this magnet close to them, these iron nails are attracted towards the magnet. This shows that these iron nails have magnetic property. Such substances that are attracted towards a magnet are called the magnetic substances. But some substances are not attracted towards the magnet. These materials are called the non-magnetic materials, such as liquid, gases, plastic, wood, etc. I show you this pen. When I bring this magnet close to them, it is not attracted towards the magnet. This shows that it doesn't have magnetic property. With this, I hope you understand all these topics. Thank you and have a nice day.